quite nice. And, of course, you need to peel this before you grate it. You can't keep the skin on.
Uh-huh.
Where with a potato, you can.
Right. So you're just demonstrating a simple grating method. We're not going to do all of that, of course.
All
but
right.
Because
well,
we've done one earlier.
Okay, you can do it on the coarse side. It wouldn't matter too
much. Makes
it a lot
faster. How do you prepare your bowl there?
Well, I would just brush that with olive oil. I tend to use olive oil and everything. All around the sides and everything. And get all your beetroot and pack it in, like really, really pack it down, sort of, as if it was like a packed down beetroot. And then just put in the oven for about 40 minutes on about, well, I'd use the old oven, like 350 degrees, whatever that might be.
And oh, I've got to learn my conversions. You've got me, what's that, about 180? Oh, we may know by the end. Yes, 180.
Oh, I hope so. Okay. So then while
Archie's so old, he does all the conversions for us.
Okay.
Yes, he does.
So now when that's about half cooked, you'd probably get around to cooking your greens. And
yes.
You just do it like I cook spinach, wash it, and while the water's still on it, just give it a bit of a shake.
Yes.
Put a little bit of olive oil in your... Hang on, where do I do this?
Yes, okay. Straight into that.
Put
into your
that
pan.
Like that. And then
that's
put
a great
all your
tip
leaves.
To use these.
Yeah, they're goodness. Just wonderful flavour. I mean, you can actually... Whoops.
There
you
we
can
have
actually
it.
Juice these as well, really. Now I just sort of have let them cook in their
There's
own
a lid
juices.
There.
Yep.
Now, Judith, you've released your seventh album, solo album. Is that right?
Yes, I have. I'm very thrilled.
It's a special, very, very special album, Let Me Find Love. Now, it's quite personal, very emotional. Do you want to talk about that?
Yes. Well, actually, the song you first played was just a bit of fun, whereas some of the songs can be fairly serious. The title track is For Love and Inspiration. It's looking for love in the world, where we all hope to find it, but inside your own heart is where to start looking first. There's a song which came about from the Hampton Rehab where I went after my car accident and a fellow patient's sister wrote this wonderful song called Hold On Tight about her sister's stroke and of course a lot of people relate to that. And I'm even singing one song half in Greek and half in English.
Really? Did you learn Greek for the song? Or?
Not really, no, I pronounced it phonetically for the recording, but I met a Greek lady there and she'd written a Greek poem which was published in the local Greek newspaper, Neos Cosmos, and she asked me to set it to music, which was the biggest challenge of my entire career, actually, yes, but I loved doing it.
Well, we'll play it a bit later and we'll break all the plates.
Okay, yes.
It's not that Greek.
Lovely idea. Yes, so there's quite a variety of music, actually, and I'm very thrilled that it's moved right up the charts.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the voice, it's interesting to know that if you want to sabotage your performances, just slip a potato into your sandwich. You really
You're
can't
right.
sing if you have starchy foods.
Absolutely. I'd have to immediately sing the blues, which I used to do with the jazz I used
oh, really?
To do, of course, yes.
That's why you spent so many years singing the blues.
Yes, I love the potato. No, not quite yet.
No.
But I do have to watch it. And I know a lot of other singers do. They avoid dairy foods and things. But I've refined it very much to sort of ripe pears and grapes and cooked broccoli I ate a lot of.
Uh-huh.
And greens generally.
I have a bit of a theory with the guys. That's probably why I don't sing so well. Too many potatoes.
Oh, well,
I'll go onto the broccoli and I'll sing for you all a bit later on.
What a good idea. I'd love
I'll
to hear
do
you.
That. Now, while the beetroot leaves are behaving like spinach,
right.
Now let's turn...
Yes. Have I got it on the...
Oh, we missed by one,
that's all right.
One spot. That'll be fine. Now, that'll just reduce down.
Okay.
Now, we have some done earlier.
Right. Yep.
Now, to do the potatoes, that's quite simple.
Yes, I leave the skin on.
Yes.
Because I really have read so many places where you actually...
How good the skin is for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, that's right. The same as we should bake a potato in its skin and never leave it behind. So I actually grate it. You can grate it fine or like on a cheese grater, but, you know, this is a good one here.
Uh-huh.
And just grate the whole thing up. And then you pack it, again, packing it quite down into a frying pan with a bit of oil on it.
Yes.
It'll probably take me a while to
Well, just
do
we've
it.
Got the principle there. So we've packed that grated potato directly into the pan.
Yep.
You cook
put
it
a
up
bit
either
of,
side.
Yep. Normally, I would grate probably both those, so it's fairly thick.
Uh-huh.
So take your pan. Yep, again, you see, I am frying, but I'm not using a lot of oil, and I am using olive oil, which I think... keeps you pretty healthy.
It does. It's a great flavour and it's quite good for you. But you obviously put a lot more into that and pack it down with...
Yes. And I leave it fairly thick, like about a centimetre thick. Because what happens then, it goes golden on the outside, like you've got here.
Yes.
And it's sort of juicy in the middle.
Yes.
And it's a lovely experience.
It's
and I think the vitamins...
It's creamy too, isn't it?
Yes. And I think the vitamins are kept really well.
Look at this.
Meanwhile, I burn my beetroot leaves.
Well, that's a good tip, letting the moisture on the outside of the leaves actually steam.
It works really well if you haven't got a steamer. I mean, I actually do now have a steamer, which has been wonderful.
Oh, they're indispensable. The Chinese steams are so affordable, too. They cost nothing.
That's right, yes. And I thought a little dessert today.
Yes?
Oh, yes, of course, my...
beetroot?
That's right. Yeah, potato, I better just keep an eye on that.
Right.
Cooks for about 4 minutes, roughly, on a medium flame for, like, one side, and you probably see the edges start to go a little bit brownie crisp. and then turn it over and cook the same on the other.
Now, your beetroot in the oven, it's baked for about how long?
About 40 minutes, I think.
Look at that.
And
Isn't that
goes so sweet when it's baked. And just slip a knife around the edge of the bowl and then just tip it out.
Like that?
Yeah.
Very simply, a great accompaniment for dessert. There we have it.
Yes, and very ripe bananas with the little black dots appearing on them, so they're really full of flavour. You just slice them lengthwise, brush a bit of aluminium foil, lie them all out, put them under the griller, and turn them again. When they're golden brown, just turn them over and you find a fork goes very softly into them and they're perfect. A little
delicious
bit of lemon juice on them.
You've just done a three-course meal in 6 or 7 minutes.
I wish I could. Coulda, woulda, shoulda.
You just did. Thank you, Judith.
Thank
well
you,
done. Thanks for this.
It's a pleasure. It looks great on you.
Coulda, woulda, shoulda, put my arms around you tight as we stood there in the shadow.